All right, Dr. Mahsa Mohebtash, Chief of Medical Oncology and Hematology from MedStar Good Samaritan Hospital, with us here now as we talk about colon cancer. Doctor, talk about what steps that a person can take to find colorectal cancer.
So people need to be aware of the signs and symptoms of colorectal cancer, like blood in stool, dark stools, abdominal pain, weight loss, or symptoms related to chronic blood loss, like fatigue, tiredness, dizziness, lightheadedness. But more importantly, people need to be aware of the screening test to find the cancer before it causes these symptoms.
And that, you know, that's tough because a lot of the symptoms are kind of the same of everything else. So what are some of the screening guidelines?
So screening guidelines are different depending on the society, but some of the societies recommend starting screening tests from age 50. Some of them have lowered the age to age 45. But this is for general population. If somebody has a strong family history of colon cancer or inflammatory bowel diseases or history of radiation to the abdomen, they have to start earlier.
Mm-hmm. And how often in between screenings?
So it depends on what they find. If they find polyps, they do it earlier. If everything is clear, depending on the type of the screening test they do, they can be annual, it could be every 3 years, every 5 years, or every 10 years.
And that was the next question. What types of screenings are there?
So we have a stool-based test, which detects blood in stool or DNA in stool.
Is that like the Cologuard?
Right, Cologuard, which detects the DNA, which is a genetic material shed by cancer cells in the lumen of the colon. And we have visual tests, which uses direct visualization of the colon, most common one being colonoscopy, which examines the whole colon, or sigmoidoscopy, which looks at the left side of the colon, or CT cholangiography, which looks at, takes pictures of the whole colon, and if they find any suspicious lesions, person needs to go through colonoscopy.
So what is the best type of screening and why?
So the best, currently the best screening test we have is colonoscopy. And the reason for that, it examines the whole colon. If there is any suspicious lesion, it can be biopsied. And it can also be preventive, because during colonoscopy, polyps, which potentially some of them can turn into cancer over the course of years, can be removed. So it can also be preventive.
You know, we think of the actor Chadwick Boseman. He seemed to be so young and so healthy, and we lost him last year to colon cancer. Is there anything you can do to prevent it?
So, you know, the data is conflicting about diet and exercise. They are, in general, good for good health, and there are some evidence it can help. But colonoscopy, removing the polyps, finding it at early stage, paying attention to signs and symptoms are very important.
All right, Dr. Mohebtash, thank you very much. Our experts are going to be standing by to take your calls until 6:30, and that number again, 410-671-0702. Mallory?
Thanks, Kelly. More people are flying again, nearly.